All right, so this video is mainly for fun. If you're not interested in rap battling, you're definitely not going to learn anything from it. So go ahead and move on to the next video. Even if you are interested in rap battling, there's not much I can cover that I haven't already covered already. Now, one thing you might have noticed at the end of the last video where I had a clip of a rap battle. Number one, all of the lyrics were pre-written. And number two, there was no instrumental whatsoever. So that might be different than what you think of when you think of a rap battle, because rap battles these days are a lot different than they used to be. So in the old days, all the rap battles used to be freestyled. And real quick, I'm just going to talk about freestyling. I know there's probably at least one person out there that is dying to know. Unfortunately, there's nothing I can say that can make you a better freestyler. Freestyling is definitely a muscle memory you just have to practice over and over again. So there is no other way to get better other than to keep repeating it. It's kind of like driving a car. It's something you just do. I can tell you all the techniques on how to drive a car, and the fact is, if you've watched all the videos up until now, I have told you all the techniques about freestyling. That involves having flow, having delivery, having multis. And you may or may not want to include multis. You may or may not want to include punchlines. All of that is optional when it comes to freestyling, because you're literally just thinking of the things that come off the top of your head. But the better you are at freestyling, the more complex the type of things you can do off the top of your head are. I've been writing punchlines for a long enough time that I can immediately think of very common concepts without putting too much thought into it. You know, if I see a book, I immediately think of, you know, okay, booking somebody into a prison system. If I see a bag, I think about, you know, putting somebody into a bag or something into a bag. You know, if I see an iPad, I immediately think of like an iPad. You know, I punch you in your eye and now you have an iPad. So these are all things that are not like super creative, but you know, if you do punchline for long enough, you get exposed to it. And you really don't have to think that much in order to like come up with these ideas. Now, the one thing I can say is it's good to practice no matter where you are, what you're doing. And the reality is I'm just naming things that I'm looking around the room and seeing. So when you want to practice freestyling, that's a good thing to do is just look around you. If you go to the grocery store, start freestyling in your mind or out loud, if you don't mind people, you know, giving you weird looks. But literally every single object you see, try to freestyle about it. You know, you see an apple, come up with a rhyme. Snapple, tackle, grapple, battle, unravel, tabernacle. The more you do it, the better your dictionary in your head is at coming up with things on the fly. And really, that's all there is to freestyling, is just practicing. You implement all the techniques that I've talked about so far, especially when it comes to rhythm and delivery. And if you do it on beat, you're going to get better at freestyling on beat. If you do it off beat, it might be a little, you know, a bit of an adjustment, but I still think that you're going to have the mechanics to freestyle on a beat. Definitely more so than if you don't freestyle at all. So moving on, I just wanted to talk about the history of battle rap. And this is not at all, you know, informative in the sense of making you a better artist. I just kind of want to talk about the history of battle rap. So back in the day in what you might call the freestyle era, almost all of the rap battles were done over beats and they were almost all freestyles. So at the top, you can actually see Eminem. He was part of a big, you know, there was a big hip hop festival called Scribble Jam and they would occasionally have rap battles. And part of how Eminem got his fame was, you know, going out and doing rap battles. He actually lost in this battle against his opponent, who's MC Juice. Though ironically, you've probably never even heard of MC Juice. Meanwhile, Eminem is arguably the most popular rapper of all time. On BET, they would also have Freestyle Fridays, which were fairly popular. However, they really only gave each person a minute to rap. They only did it on Fridays. They were very short and part of a much bigger show. And it was great that they gave, you know, freestylers and battlers a platform at that time. But it really wasn't the platform that, you know, made freestyling or rap battling, you know, a really popular thing. So the reality is there wasn't a really big, you know, fan base for rap battling. Fast forward a bit, there used to be bootleg DVDs called Smack DVDs. They would have all kinds of hip-hop content. And in those DVDs, they would also have battles where, you know, a lot of the time they would just find people out on the street and they would do battles. I'm not 100% sure about whether they were freestyled or written. I think there were definitely some people out there that were freestyling, and then there were also people that were pre-writing at the time. Either way, they were fairly popular, but not quite to the extent that battle rap is today. That being said, battle rap today still isn't quite as popular as it could be, or even as popular as it was, I think, in its prime. So around 2007, JumpOff.tv had a rap battling tournament. It definitely had a much wider demographic overall. And they published all of these rap battles on the internet. You do have to consider that, you know, the internet was still getting popularity, you know, throughout 2002, 2003. It wasn't really until MySpace became really popular that the internet really blew up with the younger generation of people. up until then, I think a lot of people who spent their time on the internet were generally like nerdy people, like me. But around 2007, the internet was definitely a lot more popular, and JumpOff.tv had a 2v2 rap battle tag team tournament. And really, it was a league that ended up with the tournament, and then there was a bunch of drama that happened, so it didn't go as well as you might have thought. However, it did get a fair amount of following, considering at the time, rap battling really wasn't very popular. Now, one thing that I think is kind of interesting, if you look at this guy right here, his name is this guy right here, his name is Organic, and then this guy right here is named Direct. All three of them went on to make rap battle leagues that became fairly popular. So Direct went on to go make Grind Time, went on to make Don't Flop, and Organic went on to make King of the Dot. Somewhere around 2009, Grind Time became really popular. At least for the first time, you were seeing consistent battles that were getting at least like 20,000 or so views. A lot of the battles were a cappella. However, unlike the JumpOff.tv, most of these battles were pre-written. At Jump Off, you know, this was pretty much all off of the top of your head. People would be freestyling, and then their partner would come in and freestyle. Although there were definitely some people using pre-written lines as well. But throughout both of these and the Smack DVDs, it had made a transition to all a cappella rap battling. So they're no longer rapping on top of a beat. So Grind Time really started to implement more production value. They had better quality cameras. As you can see, there are some more effects going on. They really started to capitalize on the internet as it started, you know, blowing up. One thing I'll say about Grind Time, it did have a fairly white demographic. And the style of rap battling back then was really heavy on multis and kind of comedy. Or even just multis in general. So just off the top of my head, you might have a line something like, "Your girl looks like a Build-A-Bear with Skrillex hair. That's really rare." There's no real punchline to it. It's kind of funny, but the main thing is that it went multi, multi, multi. And that was a very popular style back then. Grind Time was really the first online platform for rap battling that got fairly big. However, there were some managerial problems and it kind of all went under. So then after that, that was followed by Smack URL and King of the Dot. King of the Dot had been around that whole time. I also wanted to mention that Don't Flop was fairly big at one time, especially over in Europe. However, a lot of the traction that they were gaining as far as fans eventually kind of subsided and the league kind of went under. Meanwhile, the creators of the Smack DVDs saw the online success that some of the other leagues were having, and then they kind of shifted their platform onto online. So these days, rap battling isn't amazingly big, but it is big enough that a lot of famous rappers are well aware of it. For example, Drake was hosting at this particular King of the Dot event. This is Cassidy actually doing a battle. There was another battle that was hosted by P. Diddy at URL. So there's definitely a relatively big fan base for it. I mean, a lot of these battles might get anywhere between, you know, 100,000 to a couple million views. That being said, there are also still some battles that aren't even doing, you know, 10,000. And then you also see a bunch of, like, independent local leagues all popping up everywhere. So chances are, if you have any interest in battling, you can probably look around you, and you can probably find a local rap battle league, and you can really start getting into battling yourself. There's really not a whole lot I can tell you about live battling that I haven't already told you in terms of punchlines and everything. You can be a little bit more lenient on how you flow. But really, the main goal is always to get a reaction in the crowd. And if you watch enough rap battles, I think you'll get the idea. But this was kind of an extra little fun video I just wanted to do. I didn't expect it to be very long. It's not super informative. It was just a video I wanted to make for fun to kind of run through, you know, the history of rap battling. So that's about all I've got for this video. Thank you for tuning in. Check it out next time.